the good or the bad? Well, since you're not here to answer, I'll choose the bad, so then we can end on a good note. First, though, let me introduce myself. My name is India Rose Page, and this is my dog, Dash. I am 14 years old, and my birthday is on October 14th, 2002. I just completed ninth grade, attending K-12 CAVA at King's. I've been at the K-12 program for 7th, 8th, and 9th grade. My first semester of 9th grade, I actually attended high school. I remember real quick why I do much better in an online program versus being in a school environment. There's just way too much downtime in school. With K-12, I can get my assessments completed in a time frame, whether that is slow or fast. And I have more flexibility to participate on my competitive gymnastics team, travel the world with my family, and get extra assistance with school when needed. Okay, now that you know a little about me, let me fill you on the back. Before I was born, my mom and my dad made some bad choices and used drugs that they shouldn't have. Once I was born, they continued to make bad choices, and even though my dad got his life together, he unfortunately couldn't support me in a manner that in which I deserved. When I was 4 years old, my Aunt Courtney, who I love dearly, passed away from a disease called cystic fibrosis. Though I was young, I realized what it meant for Aunt Courtney to no longer be with us physically. When I was 11, my dad was diagnosed with congestive heart failure. At this time, I was already living with my grandma and grandpa, because my dad could not afford to take care of me properly. My dad died from congestive heart failure on December 4th, 2014. This was 1 month shy of his 38th birthday. Thankfully, I had my grandma and my grandpa, and they soon became my legal guardians. Also, a positive influence is my aunt, Melissa. I wish I could say that the bad stops here, but there is more. My grandpa was diagnosed with ALS in the spring of 2015, and after a struggle for 2 years, he passed away on May 23rd, 2017. It's hard enough to lose one family member, but it's devastating to lose three. Now, let's switch gears and talk about the good stuff. I am incredibly fortunate to be a part of the family that I am. We choose to focus on the positive and not the negative. We choose to be happy instead of depressed. We choose to live our lives in a manner that those that we've lost cannot. My Aunt Melissa starts her new job in Temple, Texas on July 17th. Her wife Stephanie starts as an associate warden at the federal prison in Puerto Rico on August 8th. You may ask, what does this have to do with me? Well, let me fill you in. With all the change going on, my grandma has decided to follow my Aunt Melissa first to Texas and then to Puerto Rico. I'd be lying if I said I was 100% on board with this decision. But I am also excited. I get the opportunity to be a part of a once-in-a-lifetime adventure, and for that, I am grateful. Now, back to school. Enrolling and being accepted to iAcademy would be the best possible situation for me. Getting the scholarship would be the icing on the cake. My grandma is on a fixed income, and the tuition is not feasible. If I were to be awarded the scholarship, it would help us to smoothly transition first to Texas and then to Puerto Rico. I hope that you can see why I'm the most deserving and best choice for this year's scholarship recipient. Thank you for your time, and I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day.